tuning into Liberty Under Attack Radio, your home for libertarianism in action. We provide you with real free market solutions using the freedom umbrella of direct action to give you the tools necessary to increase your own personal liberty. As Ludwig von Mises said, liberty is always freedom from the government. And now your host, Shane.
We are live. Welcome to Liberty Under Attack. Liberty Under Attack Radio, brought to you by Audible. Sign up for a free 30-day trial, download a free audiobook, and help support this broadcast in the process. Visit audibletrial.com/libertyunderattack. Again, that is audibletrial.com/libertyunderattack. So, welcome to Liberty Under Attack Radio here on the Freedom Phalanx Radio Network. Today is November 29th, 2015, and I'm your host, Shane, broadcasting live from the communist state of Illinois. I'm also joined by my co-hosts, Stan and Danny. How's it going, gentlemen?
Not tipsy yet.
That's always
I'm
good.
I'm doing pretty good.
Good to hear. So, as always, anything new on your guys' ends that you'd like to bring up?
There's a Libertarian Party, I think, coming up December 12th here in Michigan, taking place in Oakland County. I'll have to get all the details, but if anyone's interested, let me know.
All right. Yeah, get in contact with Danny. Stan, anything on your end?
No, but no party like a libertarian party, I guess.
Yeah, hopefully we're not talking about the political party, but... Hopefully it's just a party.
Little L, not big L.
I think it might actually be the big L. I think it's in Ann Arbor as well. Yeah.
Huh. Okay. Well. Get in contact with Danny if any of you are interested in that.
Maybe you can convince some of those uppercase L's that bigger isn't always better when it comes to L and libertarian.
Well, big government is always good for us, isn't it? That's what I've been taught.
Yeah. We'll send them a link to this broadcast because we're going to be discussing economic mean solutions, not any of the nonsense that the Libertarian Party is involved in. So, I was going to bring up before we move forward. I got back. I went down to Southern Illinois past couple of days to we got another piece of property down there, and I'm going to be moving out there in a couple of years after I graduate from higher level indoctrination. Otherwise known as college, to withdraw completely from society. So, yeah, I was down there doing some work on that. Yeah, all that's new on my end other than obviously celebrating anarcho-capitalism day on Thursday. That was a good time. It's definitely a good time. All right, so moving forward, Liberty Under Attack is covered by a BIPCOT no-government license. Reuse and modification is permitted to anyone and everyone except for governments or their agents. Learn more at BIPCOT.org. We've got a very special broadcast planned for you this evening. LUA Radio is hosting the very first Libertarian Roundtable. We are joined by a number of the best, most consistent minds in the Libertarian community with the objective of getting their input on the second edition of the Freedom Umbrella of Direct Action, which is set to be released here in the following month. And for those who don't know, the Freedom Umbrella of Direct Action is a value-free directory. What I mean by that is that this gives a directory of all of the economic means solutions. The efficacy has not been judged. It just gives you all of the options available for you to increase your own personal freedom, which could then translate into increasing freedom for others as well. And we'll introduce you to our panel here in just a moment. We also take calls at any point in this broadcast. The number is 218-895-3818 or on Skype at FPRN Radio Live. Alternatively, you can shoot me an email at any point in the show. That is shane@libertyunderattack.com. And as always, you can utilize the chat room available at fprnradio.com/listen-live. We'll be watching the chat, and we'll do our best to get all the questions addressed that are put in there. So all that we ask is that if you call in, please stay on topic. We are purely discussing solutions this evening, and we've surely got a lot to talk about. But one update before we get into it. I would like to point you in the direction of the website, libertyunderattack.com. I released the final installment of my Adventures in Illinois Higher Education series for this semester titled Bomb Threats, Teacher Strikes, and Black Lives Matter. The series will kick back off in January when I start at Illinois State University. So yeah, certainly a lot more in store, and I'm looking to expand that series into other avenues as well. So yeah, let's get into it. So we do have a lot of people on this call, so here's kind of what I'm thinking. I'm going to go around here to start and have each of you provide a brief introduction on who you are, what you do, and where people can find your work. After that, I'll lead off with a couple of broad, basic questions, and we can go from there. If you have something to follow up with on what someone else said, I would ask that you just say so in our private chat here in Skype, and I'll lead you in as soon as the other person has finished speaking. And one more note, the goal is to leave the floor open for all of you. I don't imagine I'll be doing a whole lot of talking other than just moderating, so to speak, and getting you guys involved in the discussion. So I guess last thing, we'll not be discussing the reformist means this evening, strictly only the economic means solutions, otherwise known as direct action. So, Mr. Producer, if you could please put the freedom umbrella of direct action on the screen for the listeners, I would definitely appreciate that. And if any of the listeners want to go check that out, it's tinyurl.com/freedom umbrella. Again, tinyurl.com/freedom umbrella. Or you can just go to libertyunderattack.com, and it's right there at the top of the homepage. So, so gentlemen, how are we all doing this evening?
Fantastic.
I'm doing good.
Good to hear.
Doing swell. Thanks for having me on the show.
Oh, not a problem. I'm getting a little feedback from you, pal. We'll start off with Nick and work our way around. So it's good to have you back on the show, Nick. And why don't you tell the listeners who you are, what you specialize in, and where they can find your work.
Yeah, thanks for having me on. I was really honored to be part of this. I'm a 17-year-old libertarian anarchist. I'm raising Tibetan yaks and some heritage breed pigs here on the farm. And I have a podcast called the Anarcho-Yakitalism Podcast, and you can find that at an-yak.com and-yak.com. And I also do some radio show co-hosting with the Freedom Fiends, and you can find that at thefreedomfiends.com. Or not thefreedomfiends.com, but F-E-R-R. No, I don't know how to spell it. It's just freedomfiend.com, so you'll find it.
freedomfiends.com, yep. Yep. Okay, well, thank you very much, Nick. Next was Mark Wood, but yeah, it looks like Mark didn't make it this evening. But Mr. Kal Molinet, it's always a pleasure. I think this is the third time we've had you on the broadcast. Why don't you tell the listeners who you are, what you specialize in, and where they can find your work.
I'm Kal, destroyer of socialism from the House of Anarchy of the River City of Richmond, Virginia. I guess you can say... anarchist whisperer. I do a lot of work in spreading anarchy and introducing the the most important conversation in the world to new people, and to kind of bring them outside of the matrix and be a part of a community that's already in line with their moral values against the state. And most of my work can be found at liberaterva.com. RVA is the initial for Richmond, Virginia.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you very much, Kal. And Kyle Rearden, we can't even really call you a guest anymore, but welcome back once again. Let the listeners know who you are, your specialty, and where they can find your work.
Sure. I'm an anti-political libertarian blogger. The blog is located at, and it's kindly provided by FPRN, at The Last Bastille. Bastille is spelled B-A-S-T-I-L-L-E, thelastbastille.com. I'm also the author of An Elusive Phantom of Hope, A Critique of Reformism, which is available exclusively for free download off of the Liberty Under Attack website. I specialize in law, economics, and combat.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you very much, Kyle. And Davi, welcome back. It's been about a month and a half for you as well. So, yeah, same as the others. Let the listeners know who you are, your specialties, what you do, and where they can find your work.
Sure. My name is Davi Barker. People may know me from a lot of different places. I'm sometimes a co-host on the Freedom Fiends. I run shinybadges.com. Recently, I published my second zombie novel at survivormax.com, so I wear a lot of different hats. But I guess I'm prominent in this community as an active agorist, so that's how people probably know me.
Okay, okay, awesome. Well, thank you very much, Davi. And before we get started, I'd like to read a quote from, it's actually in the article, but it's from Albert J. Knox, Our Enemy, the State. Quote, "There are two methods or means, and only two, whereby man's needs and desires can be satisfied. One is the production and exchange of wealth. This is the economic means. The other is the uncompensated appropriation of wealth produced by others. This is the political means. The primitive exercise of the political means was, as we have seen, by conquest, confiscation, expropriation, and the introduction of a slave economy. The conqueror parceled out the conquered territory among beneficiaries, who thenceforth satisfied their needs and desires by exploiting the labor of the enslaved inhabitants. The feudal state and the merchant state, wherever found, merely took over and developed successfully the heritage of character, intention, and apparatus of exploitation which the primitive state transmitted to them. They are in essence merely higher integrations of the primitive state. The state then, whether primitive, feudal, or merchant, is the organization of the political means. Now, since man tends always to satisfy his needs and desires with the least possible exertion, he will employ the political means whenever he can, exclusively if possible, otherwise in association with the economic means." End quote. And that's from Albert J. Knox's book, Our Enemy, the State. And again, that's what we're going to be discussing this evening, the economic means of making money. So let's go ahead and I guess get into this first question here. And I'm just going to kind of go randomly here. So Kyle, you mentioned your specialty was obviously spreading anarchy, promoting libertarian principles and such. So can you tell us what strategies have been successful for you? Increased freedom in your personal life, increasing freedom in other people's lives. What strategies have been successful for you? And what have you found not to be effective in your work?
Right. That's the only kind of freedom you can really push forward is personal freedom. The most that I can do with my interactions with other people is just provide facts and evidence. And so it's not so much I'm out there trying to persuade anyone or convince anyone, or some people say proselytize. I'm just merely presenting facts and evidence and in a setup in a way that makes it easier to digest that information and to come to the conclusion of the state, of agreeing with the argument against the state. And I have a very successful method that I have online on YouTube. I have nearly 300 recorded individual interviews showing how effective it is and how the success rate of that is over 90% of everyone agreeing of the argument of the government being immoral and agreeing with taxation being theft and aligning with their moral values that they also find it to be wrong and immoral to initiate force. And that I find to be, I guess kind of helps with my personal freedom because, I'm only as free, I guess you could say, because we're trapped here as prisoners until everyone realizes that this is a cage and we can kind of unite together and then finally abolish that cage. And I can't do that alone. And that's going to take a strong community willpower of courageous people to pull that off together. And so I guess what I found, what hasn't worked for me, politics, right? When has politics ever worked for anyone? No factual evidence to show and history that politics has ever achieved freedom for anyone. And so seeing that we are an anarchist organization, we seek to bring consistency with the message of anarchism, being against political rulers. Doesn't mean with exceptions. Sometimes it could be political rulers, you know, if they're your best friend or you yourself run as a slave master. And we find our non-political stance to be even a great draw for a lot of people, especially our target market audience, you know, millennials, people who are Republicans or Democrats. People can't tell the difference between like socialism and capitalism, you know, due to that Rupert study report from Reason.com. Great, I could work with that. And but if I were to say that we're a political organization, they'll associate us with the Libertarian Party, and that is nothing that we want to be seen as.